I have been a missionary to Taiwan for over 20 years. I went to Taiwan in 1997, studied Mandarin Chinese, and continued my theology in Chinese at Furen Catholic University. In 2018, I was granted a Taiwanese or a Taiwan citizenship. Now I have a double identity, Filipino by birth and a Taiwanese by citizenship, or a naturalized Taiwanese. My given name is Conrad in Filipino, but it became my family name in Chinese. If you could see it, my Chinese name is Kong Lü De. Kong Zi De Kong, Fa Lü De Lü, Dao De De De, Kong Lü De. So my Chinese name is Kong. Kong is Confucius. Lü is law. De is a virtue. So my Chinese name means a virtuous and law-abiding person. Wow. According to Confucius, your name is something you live by. You live by your name. And in the Chinese culture, a person can change his or her name up to 3 times in his lifetime. They want their names to be meaningful. Thomas was also called Didymus, a Greek word which means twin. So I have a question. Does Thomas have a twin brother? No. It's just his name. And Thomas is true to his name. Thomas had a twin personality. Yes. And his nickname is Doubting Thomas. The writer Henry Nouwen, or Nouwen, a Dutch priest, in his book, The Genesee Diary, mentioned that the fathers of the church commented that all of us are two people. All of us are two people. Why? A doubting one and a believing one. So we need the support and love of our brothers and sisters, our family, in our community to prevent our doubting person from becoming dominant and destroying our capacity for belief. So today, the feast of Saint Thomas the Apostle, the message for us is to reflect not so much on the doubting Thomas as on the living and dynamic faith of the community where we belong, the church, in which or of which Thomas was a part. Let me share you a personal story. In 1999, I went to Beijing, China, for my pastoral exposure. I got into a serious illness and was hospitalized for a blood clot in my brain, in my left brain. The doctor said, I need to undergo an operation. I got scared And so I did not consent to the brain surgery. I had to take daily medication to avoid seizure. It was a turning point in my life, not knowing whether I would survive or not, not knowing whether I would still see my family. And I was really down and emotionally distressed. But you know, what kept me going was the understanding and support of my brothers in the community. They took care of me while I was in the hospital. My brothers, they gave me the courage to face my fear. I had my treatment here in the Philippines through medication. And I returned to Beijing after my treatment so I could be with them once again. And thanks be to God, my health condition has returned to normal. I consider this healing moment an experience of seeing the resurrected Jesus, which was possible or became possible through the fraternal love of the community or the community that has shown me. Although Thomas, a skeptic, did not initially believe in the resurrection of the Lord, he remained faithful to the call he had received from Jesus. And what call is that? The call to be a part of the community of the apostles. While his doubts would not allow him to believe that the other had seen the Lord, Thomas was never lost faith in their brotherhood. And it was ultimately in and through that community that Thomas finally encountered the risen Christ. And speaking of community spirit, one of our speakers in the NEMI course I attended in Rome, Father Dennis McBride, a Redemptorist priest from Scotland, shared that Saint Bernard once wrote a very interesting note to his brothers, and I quote, "If you do not have an impossible brother in your community, go out and find one." Father McBride said that most of us do not have to go out and get one, and most of us have busloads already. So Saint Bernard's point is interesting. He said, if you surround yourself in community with people just like you, or who are just like you, how will you learn forbearance? How will you learn charity? How will you learn forgiveness? And Jesus argued, you are living a forbearing community if you are living in a community that had forgiveness at the ready. So today, let us acknowledge the Thomas in us. Let us acknowledge the twin personality in us, a believing one and a doubting one. When dominated by the doubting person, let us hold on to the support and love of our family, our community, our friends. And let us also strive to strengthen the band of our family and our community. For at the end of the day, it is they who will stay with us through thick and thin. Not everyone got to be with Jesus when he was alive on earth. No, we have never seen him with our eyes. We only saw Jesus in photos or movies. We have not been able to touch him with our hands. No. But we still believe Jesus calls us blessed. We are blessed even though we did not see him. We did not touch him. And that's true faith. That's true faith. It is easy to believe in something that you could see. Not so easy to believe in something that you could not see. But we know in our hearts, we know for real that Jesus is real, that Jesus is true, and that he promised us that he will be with us always. Amen? Amen. So just like air, we can see it, but we believe it exists. It keeps you alive. Or the oxygen that keeps you alive when you get infected by the virus. It's there. We can see Jesus, but he keeps us alive every single day. Yes, sometimes it's difficult to believe. And that is why we need to pray. We need to pray and ask God to strengthen our faith and give us gentle reminders to help us believe every single day. I would like to end my homily reflection with a song. I hope it will inspire us to believe once more or to strengthen our faith and believe every single day. If you know the song, let us sing together.
I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows. I believe for everyone who goes astray, someone will come to show the way. I believe, oh, I believe. I believe above the storm, the smallest prayer will still be heard. I believe that someone in the great somewhere hears every word. Every time I hear a newborn baby cry, or touch a leaf, or see the sky, then I know why. I believe. Every time I hear a newborn baby cry, or touch a leaf, or see the sky, then I know.